Hello, I'm Mona.
And I'm Melody.
And we're here with this week's video announcements.
There's only one more week before break, and with Valentine's Day next week, it's sure to be one you love. If you're looking for something more to love, here's some information about Mills Art and Makerspace Clubs.
Hello, Mills students in 5th through 8th grade. This is Mrs. Domstead. Do you enjoy coding, electronics, robotics, wood crafts, inventing, Legos, doing puzzles, creating art, or solving math puzzles? Then please join us in Makerspace Club. It is starting up on Monday, February 12th at 8 o'clock in the library. I look forward to seeing you there.
Mill Herd is at full gallop. Let's get up to speed with all that's going on.
Herd is collecting items for the Williamsville Food Pantry.
Please donate toothbrushes, toothpaste, soap, deodorant, or personal care items.
Collection will take place from February 5th to February 16th.
Collection bins are outside the main office in front of the auditorium.
Help someone in need.
Do you know all of Mill's amazing clubs? Let's check in with Mona and learn a bit about Mill's Social Justice Club.
So what exactly is Social Justice Club?
So we come and every day Mr. Jones has a bunch of slides, and there's usually a topic, and we do a community circle with some questions, and we discuss our opinions on these topics.
So what kind of topics do you talk about?
So we talk about differences in our school, intersectionality, and a lot of issues that people face in the school and elsewhere.
So who runs Social Justice Club?
Mr. Jones, and I think Mr. Daniel will be joining soon.
Who can join and how can we join?
So there's no permission slip. Anyone can just come to the meetings and sign in. And it's pretty great.
So what makes people want to join?
Yes, snacks. And juice. And so every day when you come in, you can invite your friends and we get to talk in a supportive environment. What is said in the circle stays in the circle. And also snacks. It's time to check in with our book bloggers and see what book they're reviewing this week.
I'm Annabelle.
I'm Izzy.
And we're the book bloggers. We're back with a new book, Sisters by Raina Telgemeier. 3 weeks, two sisters, one car. A true story. Raina can't wait to be a big sister. But once Amara is born, things aren't quite the way she expected them to be. Amara is cute, but she's also a cranky, grouchy baby, and mostly prefers to play by herself. Their relationship doesn't improve much over the years, but when a baby brother enters the picture, and later, when something doesn't seem right between their parents, they realize they must figure it out to get along. They are sisters, after all.
This book is part of the series.
You can find this book in the public and school libraries, as well as a lot of teacher libraries.
A quote from the book is, "You don't see stars like this city." Here's Henry with this week's On Location segment.
Hello, Mill Mustangs. Valentine's Day is just around the corner, and love is in the air. I've decided to ask some students and teachers what they love most about Mill. From the caring teachers who go above and beyond, to the amazing friendships they've formed, Mill Middle School has captured the hearts of its students. Let's hear firsthand what makes this school so special, and why it is a place filled with love and joy.
Hi, Maya. Hi, Mallory. What do you guys love most about Mill?
Jazz band.
Hi, Zoe. What do you love about Mill?
I love walking club with Bronco and Friday mornings.
Hi, Mary. What do you love most about Mill?
What I love most about Mill is the extra activities you get to do in and out of school.
What do you love most about Mill?
Henry, what I love most about Mill is the students and the teachers here. Being brand new, everyone has been so warm and welcoming, and they've made me feel like part of the family.
Hi, Gigi. What do you like most about Mill?
So I like that I can meet all my nice friends.
Hi, Ella. What do you love most about Mill?
I love all the teachers and, like, they're all nice and stuff.
Hi, Miss Grant. What do you love most about Mill?
I love my sixth graders the most and also my sixth grade colleagues. It's the best working here.
There we go.
What do you guys love most about Mill?
Social Justice Club!
I like Social Justice Club because of community circles and friends.
Something I like about Social Justice Club is the snacks, and it's also, and we talk about stuff such as, like, with discrimination in the world, and how to fix it, bullying, and how to fix it, and other stuff.
What I love most about social justice is the ability to talk about issues in our world and try to come up with abilities to fix them and make the world a better place. I also really like the snacks.
What I love most about social justice is how we can talk about what's wrong in the world and how we can make a change.
What do you love most about it?
I like the intramurals and all the world languages. I take French and thank you, Miss Lipko.
Hi, Colin. What do you love most about Mill?
I love intramurals and basically all the extracurricular activities.
Hi, Evan. Hi, Henry. What do you guys love most about Mill?
Jazz band.
Perfect. Jeremy, what do you love most about Mill?
My favorite thing about Mill Middle School has to be my students. Especially the ones that end up on my wall as my estudiantes del mes. I love being able to work with all different grade levels and meet all different kids from different families and teach siblings of children that I know. So the kids are definitely my favorite.
Here's Kiara with our weekly tech tip.
Hi, I'm Kiara Peterson, and I'm here with this week's tech tip. If you have a crazy amount of tabs open like this, try this. Click on it with two fingers and press delete. Bye!
We hope you have an amazing day and a wonderful weekend. Go Mill, go Bills, go Sabres, and go Billies!
Hey Mel, next week is Spirit Week. Let's get ready for midwinter break and enjoy some fun. On Monday, dress like your favorite Mel teacher. On Tuesday, find a friend or two and be twins. On Wednesday, show your love and wear your favorite Valentine's colors. On Thursday, get tropical and bold. And on Friday, get cozy comfy and enjoy your pajama day. We can't wait to see your Mel Spirit Week looks.
Hello, Mill Middle School, and especially those 7th and 8th graders who are going to the dance tonight. Just a few reminders. The dance begins at 6:30 and will go through 8:30 this evening. When you arrive, you'll form in two lines, one for 7th grade students, one for 8th grade students, where you'll present your ticket to get in. You should have received this ticket, or will shortly, in home base this morning. If you did not receive one, please see Mr. Garlopo in the tech office during your lunch today. Pickup will be prompt at 8:30 in the evening. 7th graders, you will be picked up at the end of A-Wing where the buses come in. Please let your parents know. And 8th graders, you will be picked up in front of the school by the main office door. We look forward to seeing you. And a reminder that all school rules do apply, so make sure dress and your use of cell phone is appropriate. And we look forward to seeing you and having a good time with you this evening. We'll be right back.
I won't buy anything with Velcro. It's a ripoff.
What did the farmer say when he lost his tractor? Where's my tractor?
What do you call an old snowman? A glass of water.
My name is Henry Noe, and today I'm on location at Channel 4.
We are so excited to be here with you this morning, Henry.
Henry's taking over my job. You know what, Colleen, why don't you give us a little background about why you brought Henry in today?
Okay. Henry is an aspiring journalist, as you can tell, and he is amazing at what he does. He's a sixth grade student at Mill Middle School, and he has his segment, Henry on Location, and he does stories for the school. And I'm going to let you explain the details of that, Henry.
Okay, so how I started Henry on Location is I was in this club called Video Announcements, and I couldn't go to the club meetings anymore. So, I still want to do this because I love talking and I love sharing good things. So I decided to branch off and do my own segment called Henry on Location.
I love it.
What's some of the places you've been able to go out and report?
Well, there's this club called Herd, and I usually do most of my reports involving that. It's a community service club. And I've gone to the Ronald McDonald House, I've done food drives, I've done Catholic Charities, and there's this guy named Trey, and he's a free hugs guy on our street, and he's super nice. And I interviewed him for Kindness Month. I also did WNY Heroes, which is this place for veterans.
How cool is it that you get to go to all these different locations and talk to people and hear their stories?
It's super fun. And almost all these people are so nice, and they just are so welcoming to me interviewing them, and it's fun to be able to learn these things because some of these things that I've been interviewing, I never knew about.
Mm-hmm. What does it mean for you to be able to also give back? Because you're going to places like Ronald McDonald's, Catholic Charities, so you're also volunteering and doing great work.
It means a lot to me to be able to do all this stuff. Herd is a great club, and I'm so glad that I'm in it, and then I get to do all these interviews.
Now, Colleen, how did you and Hope Rises find Henry and want to promote his story?
Henry is the next generation of Hope Rises. He is sharing good news already, which is what we love. We're trying to spread good news, right, through Hope Rises. So to see, you know, students doing this and you doing it at your middle school and, you know, trying to spread kindness and hope throughout Mill Middle, it just puts a smile on our face. So we thought this is the perfect match for Hope Rises, and we had to promote you this morning.
Thank you so much. Do you mind if I ask you guys some questions?
Oh, please, take it away.
Okay, first, Colleen, what inspired you to become a part of Hope Rises?
Well, that's a really good question. So I was actually a teacher in Williamsville for 15 years, and my son, Jackson, who you met earlier, was diagnosed with a rare disease when he was 2. And it kind of changed my life path a little bit, where I just really started focusing on giving back to the community. We're so grateful for so many things that were done for our family. And it kind of led into doing Hope Rises with Miss Kate through Daytime Buffalo and Channel 4. And now every Wednesday, I get to leave with the biggest smile on my face because I get to share stories about people like you, Henry.
Your job is so amazing, and I want to be this when I grow up, and I really want to come back.
I love it.
And number two, what inspired you to, and what do you think would be, like, some advice for people who want to take your job?
Well, Henry, I think you're coming for my job right now, and I'm so okay with it because you're doing great. But, you know, the biggest part is, like you said, you have to be okay and willing and happy to talk to people and give them the space to open up and share their stories. And you're practicing right now and what you do with, you know, your Henry on Location, being able to talk to the camera and go out and feel comfortable on the screen, not just behind it. I think you're doing great.
Thank you. Your job is amazing, and I'm really glad that you were the person to interview me. And you too.
Thank you.
And finally, what time do you get up in the morning? Because this seems like a pretty early job.
Okay, so I think I wake up later than most of the people that work here at Channel 4. I get up at 4:15 every morning.
Wow.
I bet Kelsey has gotten up earlier than that throughout her career, possibly.
I definitely have.
Thank you so much for letting me come to Channel 4. And Henry on location, signing off.
Oh my God, Henry, I think you did an amazing job. I'm so excited to see where your career
Thank
goes.
You.
You're already killing it.
Thank you so much.
Where would you like to work? Would you like to work at Channel 4?
Any spot where I get to be a newscaster, but Channel 4 would be amazing. I'd be so happy if I
Any openings
work here.
Right now?
I know some people, so maybe we can get you in here.
Thank you so much.
What do you think? Do you think you're going to continue to keep on doing Henry on the Street and working to give back to the community?
Yes, definitely. I love doing this, and I don't think I'll ever stop. I love this.
Alrighty. Oh, you just made my day, Henry. I'm so excited to see where you go. And thank you for sharing these amazing stories. You're doing great, kid.
Thank you.
All right. Of course, Hope Rises strives to share the very best and most uplifting stories of Western New York. To keep up to date with them, find them on Facebook and Instagram at Hope Rises Network. Thank you again for coming in.